In a region accused by the US and others of harboring and funding some of the world's most wanted men, a conference on how to combat terrorism may appear problematic. The host country, Iran, for example, is on the US list of state sponsors of terrorism, accused of funding groups like Hezbollah. President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad kicked off the summit by turning the table on such accusations. Delegates were shown footage of incidents such as Israel's attack on the Mavi Marmara aid ship heading for the Gaza Strip and the downing of an Iranian passenger plane by the United States in 1988.
It is unfortunate for me to announce that the individuals and groups responsible for these terrorist incidents are under the protection of some European governments and US politicians.
Sudan's President Omar al-Bashir, who's wanted by the International Criminal Court for genocide and war crimes, said Western countries use double standards.
Such methods of aggressions and occupations used by the dominant powers against our nations must be stopped. They use phrases and words to reach their own sordid aims and portray others as aggressors, where it is us who have been pummeled by domineering powers.
Officials from more than 50 countries are attending the Tehran meeting, including regional neighbors Afghanistan and Pakistan. Both those countries face huge security challenges, particularly the threat of armed groups such as the Taliban and Al-Qaeda trying to destabilize their nations.
The central challenge of our times since the dawn of the century, and indeed even before it, has been the rise of the extremism and militancy. We have no other option except to fight and defeat it, because defeat for us is not an option.
While everyone at the conference seems to agree on the magnitude of the issues facing their countries, finding long-lasting and meaningful solutions remain elusive. Nazanin Sadri, Al Jazeera.